Hello, in this video, I will try to present you some reasons for using URL shorteners. I use lots of extensions for links. So this is for copying the title and URL of the current blog post or the current page I'm visiting. This is for opening lots of links, so I can just select all this text, and now if I would click this one, it will open all the links. And this is for URL shortening. Okay, so what is URL shortening? This URL, which is a very long one, I can make it short by just clicking on this extension. And now the URL is this. And when I click enter, it sends me to the big URL. So this is what URL shortening is. It's been around for a while. I've heard of it in the first years of 2000. And I started using it since 2004, something like that, 2005 perhaps. I used it quite a lot since then. The reason is lots of links look like this, and even on my blog, if I just put it like this, it occupies a lot of space. So this is much more convenient. And if it's simple to... So if I just click on this, open the link, and now I just click the button and it's already copied in the... clipboard, to me it's so simple that I can use it quite a lot. Okay, so which URL shortener to use? The oldest URL shortener I know of is tinyurl. Of course, perhaps there might have been others at that time, but it was very used until a new one appeared. So very popular. Unfortunately, it's very Spartan, so you don't have too many statistics. You don't know too many things about the URL you create. You can put preview. So if this is the URL you get by shortening a URL, you can put preview. So let's just copy this blog post. And now if I click this, it will open the tiny URL, which will redirect. But if I would just copy the preview button and click enter, now it doesn't send me directly, it just proceeds. And I don't want preview, so I will just disable it. Okay. There's a tool called Web Sniffer, which does the following. So you see this is the URL, and it should redirect to the following URL. But the redirection can be done in more than a single way, and I want to make sure that for SEO purposes, for search engine optimization purposes, tinyurl does the right thing. And it seems it does, because look, it says here that the redirection was 301, and this is the best redirection you can currently have, I know of. So it sends to this URL, so not to some other link, and it's 301, and this is fine. Okay. You can have, this is an older article, it's from 2009, but they analyzed more than the three URLs I analyzed, so you could have a look, but you should check, because it's 4 years since the article has been written. tinyurl, it's longer than other competitors, because it has more than so bit.ly has three letters plus three, it's six. Twitter has t.co, which is four letters, so tinyurl has 11. But to me this is a very if you use it on Twitter it matters, but on pretty much anywhere else it doesn't matter if it's 3 or 10 or 11. And it's easy to type. If I tell someone to type, go to tinyurl.com, it will immediately know how to type. If I dictate, look, go to bit.ly, or go to Google, or go to Oli, or something like that. It's much harder to type. tinyurl.com, it's easy to dictate and to type. So it's not so bad. I don't mind this length of the URL. The problem is that the URL is very long. So the tinyurl website is very was made long time ago. This is how it looked in 2003, and it's not too much different than what today looks like. What it looks like today. So it doesn't have a preview. In 2003, it didn't have a preview, and I don't know. I think it doesn't copy automatically. Was it something else? And now you can have custom URL. So if you go to, let's take this URL and go to tinyurl, and I want this custom beautiful URL. Let's make another one. It gave me an error. Okay, so this is my URL. So it looks nice. So I can just copy it and paste it, and it leads me to this. Oh, it's nice. This is a good thing about tinyurl. But despite all this quality, it's just an old service. So I don't get any statistics. Nobody gets any statistics, and it's just too old for my fashion. So things have changed. I changed. So if I give someone who is an internet marketer a link with tinyurl, okay, it's not so bad, but if I have no advantage of using it in front of Google or Bitly, I use another service. Okay, so the next one I switched to was Bitly. This one has some advanced features. You should have a look on this article. It has a lot of features. It integrates with other services. So my personal feature of using Bitly was integrated with my Last.fm, and it records what I am. So I listen to Last.fm, and using this website, I can connect to my Last.fm with Bitly, and it records everything I listen to. So most of, I think like 8,000 of these are just Last.fm songs, which is fine. It doesn't matter. It's okay. Perhaps I occupy the internet with boring stuff, but to me this is important to know what I listen to at a given time. So I prefer to have it. And it's like some sort of a backup for my Last.fm profile. So it's nice. And other services integrate with them with Bitly quite a lot. Twitter and so on. It was just an example to show you that it's much more likely to have a service integrate with Bitly than with anything else. So if Last.fm integrates with Bitly, most likely a Twitter client also integrates with Bitly. Okay. The stats show that Bitly has some size, so it's not a small company. You can create a custom URL with Bitly. So let's take this URL and let's make custom. Look, it detected that if at some point the link you are sharing also has another URL shortener, it may give you this, which is nice. So I prefer to have Bitly give me this EFTT link rather than some with Bitly. So I prefer to use this one. So I like this feature a lot. But I think it might be related that perhaps EFTT, this website, I think it might have some connection with Bitly, and that's why they do it. I'm not sure. But I checked the YouTube links and the Google Maps links, and they don't have this feature. So I think this shortening service was actually also offered by Bitly. I'm not sure. Anyhow, you can have this custom link. And now it leads me to EFTT. So this is nice also. You can use it as a bookmark manager, but to me it's a feature which I don't like seeing so much. So yes, if you have all sorts of extensions and you always use Bitly, perhaps it's nice to use Bitly as a bookmark manager and sharing lists and all sorts of things. To me, it's just bloatware. You know, when you install Nero, software for writing DVDs, it comes with all sorts of things which you don't necessarily need or want, like playing videos and audio and ripping MP3s and those MP3 files and so all sorts of things, which I don't need. I just wanted to write DVDs, and it's the same with Bitly. I just wanted to shorten my links, not, I don't know, grids or all sorts of features that, which I don't need. So I'm not a fan of this. This is a bit more interesting. If you have a domain, you can use Bitly to create short URLs for that domain. I wouldn't use it. To me, so the problem with this is that it's just another layer of something which I don't need. So I prefer to create on my blog my URLs to be short for the first time. So right from the beginning to have them made short URLs, and not worry too much about which URL shortening service to use. Because think about it, if you have another domain, you have to worry about one more thing, so each year to pay the domain and to make sure it works. And I don't know, to me it's just another layer of something which I don't need. So it looks nice, but I don't prefer it so much. The most important thing about Bitly is statistics. So let's sort my links by clicks. And let's take... this is an article I shared. And let's see some stats. It had 400 clicks. Okay. I shared it long time ago. Almost no clicks. Let's see this. 2 clicks, I don't know. Somehow in September 2007, I got some clicks. And it gives you, this should be more like this, but it is really fragmented because it's a very long link. And most people clicked on email. And most people are from Romania. And it gives you some other data. Let's take another link. Let's see some stats. So again, most of the links were at the beginning. This was shared on Twitter and Facebook. Most people are from Romania or no location. And I shared this link. Okay. So let's get some other statistics. My Team Forest now. Let's take this one. I'm not sure if it works. It worked. Okay, so I think the search engine land uses Bitly. That's why they have this. Let's use it for, I don't know, last 30 days. So you see it's more like this or all time. I don't know why it looks like that. This is, I think something was wrong with this, anyhow. So, yeah, this is how statistics look like. There's also something wrong with the geographic, this can't be true, so. What is this? So, I clicked. So, I know I clicked the link, but I'm not sure why only Romania displays here. If I click all time, I have some bugs, but generally it will show you demographics like this. Okay. So, statistics are the most important reasons for using Bitly. If you add the plus to the end of the URL, you get more statistics. So, by visiting this, you get the link. And by visiting this with the plus at the end, you get statistics about the link. So you know where you land, you know what the link is, who created it, you know some things about the author of the link. And which other people visited. Okay, the pro version doesn't have too many features for me to make it attractive. I don't know. The biggest drawback abused by snapspammers. So I see a lot of links used with Bitly in context with affiliate networks and stuff like that. So I prefer to use a network which is less used by spammers. I don't know, perhaps I'm wrong, but this is my personal observation. Okay. Google is by the is made by the same company who gives us Google Analytics, but their information is less authoritative. So let's take this link, which is, as you can see from here, it has the highest number of clicks. So I made these are mostly made in the past day just to write this article. Anyhow, let's take one link and see what it gives us. So the link was probably made here, and the next day it got some links. It gives us details about browsers, referral, countries and platforms. The thing is, it's not relevant. So Bitly knew that those two are Facebook. So I would prefer to give me more aggregate data to do the work for me, and instead of okay, I will give you the exact numbers, who cares? So this is Google. I don't care google.com.br. I don't Brazil. I don't. So look, these two should be the same. Facebook. It has three Facebook. Four. So just give me one with Facebook. It's much more relevant than give me all these pies. Okay. So Macintosh. Okay, perhaps they group this, but I would prefer to you have it, I don't know, just it's too much fragmentation. So this is all Windows, but they tell me iPad and iPhone. I don't know, perhaps these statistics are less relevant to me than the ones offered by Bitly, even though they're much more comprehensive. So it tells me the browsers. Okay, so for one or two links, it's okay. You can determine some things. Okay, most people use Chrome. What would that mean? But generally, it doesn't mean too much if people use Chrome or Internet Explorer. You can have a look at one or two links, but it's not something I would want to see for every link which I share. Look, it gives me this. I don't even know what this is, but so three people use I don't know what browser. Okay, but this is not relevant to me. So yeah, I'm not very fan of this. I like this. So we give you, it when you create a short URL, it also gives you a QR code. This is nice. It's a nice addition. So you can put this in a book or in a printed material, and this is fine. Quite a nice idea. I should write this down. Let's open a notepad. QR code. Okay. I'll forget it otherwise. Okay. You can set custom URLs, or I think I wasn't able to find any, so okay. If you go to Bitly and you are not logged in, you can create a short URL. If you go to Google and you are not logged in, you can create a short URL, but you need to fill in a security code, and this is not so nice. Also, if you are not logged in, you can't see statistics for the URL. So adding a plus if you are not logged into Google isn't working so well. As you see, these kind of links were used by Google some while ago, and it shows me that the interface hasn't been updated so much. And this means that probably Google doesn't put so much emphasis on making this up to date. So to me, this is a sign that Google doesn't put too much emphasis on this software. So I'm not, if I would to use URL shortener more professionally, perhaps I would consider Bitly, which I don't know, I think they put much more emphasis on their interface than Google. Okay, they also have SEO friendly redirection. So why do I use Google more than anything else? Because the trust it gives me. So if I shorten a URL with Google and I give that URL to a person, that person will trust me. Oh, look, a URL about Google. Okay, it's trustworthy. This is the most important reason. The other one that Google might probably never disappear, okay, it's fine, but Bitly, surely, I think it's on the same league, so it's over there. Okay. If you go to YouTube and share a URL, it gives you a short URL, so YouTube, LinkedIn, Flickr, they give you a short URL. You should use them. You should use the short URL these providers give you. It's easy, you just copy-paste, so yeah, it's fine. These are fine. Also, there's a company in Romania called Vertify, and they have their own URL shortener. Quite a good idea. Okay. For these two, yes, perhaps you would use short URLs if the company providing the solution also has short URLs. Okay. But I wouldn't use them. So if you want to use some other software other than Google or Bitly or tinyurl.com, so other than that, or the short URLs for the service, you like YouTube, like LinkedIn, like Flickr, like Twitter, like Google Maps. Other than that, I would read some things about the software provider. So I'm not too much trustworthy. I don't put so much trust that they will exist on the market for years to come. So I would think about it for a while. Okay, why use them? So if you want to send the URL via instant messaging or email or SMS, and the person trusts you, and you're in a hurry and you want to send the URL, okay, I repeated this. Yes, you can send the URL via shortening service, or a short URL. But the source medium must be something in which it will display poorly. So in Twitter it displays well, in Facebook it displays well, but an instant messaging, an email, and an SMS doesn't look good. So yes, use a short URL service. The person must trust you, so if I say send someone a link with tinyurl.com, it might wonder what's with the link. But if the person trusts you, this shouldn't be a problem. And if you want something quick and easy and a fast solution, and in the next 2 days it wouldn't matter if the link is valid or not, then just use the tinyurl. There's a special case for using short URLs, referring to data you aren't in control of. So let's say you have a real estate agency, and there are 10 agents which work for you, and you want to give them each a link to your website, and you could in theory just create links such as this, but it's a very long URL. This is a URL, this is a URL. And if someone knows a bit about internet, they would just cut this. But if they cut this, you have no referral data. So in that case, it's just best to take this an URL such as this and just put it in Bitly. So now it's a long URL. So to me, this is a good solution. Use Bitly and use Google Analytics to get referral data. To me, this is a nice solution. Another option is when you don't control the link anymore. So if you put a link on a social network which doesn't give you statistics about the clicks you got. So perhaps you put a link on a Facebook group and you don't own the group and you don't know how many people saw the link. You don't know how many people clicked on the link. And you also don't control the destination. So you don't know how many people clicked on the link based on the traffic on that website. In that case, it's good to use a shortening service. In affiliate marketing, it's a long story. Generally, I would use affiliate links which are shortened by URL, by shortening services, but it's a bit trickier because the person might not trust you. So if you give someone this link and it has this on it, the person might not trust you. So just think about it prior to taking a decision such as this. So this link, if I give someone this link, it just it can just cut this prior to clicking it. So you can the person can copy the link and now cut it, and now it's gone. But if I give a link such as this, it now just refer to. Okay. I will not go into details. I detailed in the article. Okay. Another reason to use short URLs is that they might display poorly on a blog. So this is the case in here. So if you print an article, a book, a dissertation paper, you might consider using short URLs or QR codes. I show you Google has them. So this is a good thing. And this is a shortcut, QR code. Okay. This is a little less okay for vanity. So if you give someone a link, this might look better. So look, if I give you this link, you might be tempted to click more easily. Or look, this one. No, it's just personalized. So it's the same link, but using a short URL, it's called vanity URL. You make people proud of them. Okay, there are some reasons when you should refrain from using URL shorteners. So, on the long term, consider that it might not work. Generally, this isn't the case, so I detailed it here. Most likely, Google or TinyURL or Bitly, they will work forever. Also, if YouTube works, U2.be might work for a while, for the same time. If Twitter works, probably t.co will always work, and stuff like that. So they are so inherently connected that if Twitter works, t.co works. So I think you are fine with this. But don't just take any URL shortening service because perhaps at some time it might disappear. So I don't like putting people to have fear. I don't like creating fear. It's something called FUD. Face uncertainty and doubt. Okay. So I will link this. I'm not sure. Perhaps I'm very false with this affirmation, but just remember that it might also be true. Okay. URL shorteners are abused by spammer. So if I send you a link to buy from mywebsite.com, you might be tempted not to click on it. But if I shorten it with Bitly or TinyURL or Google, you won't know what's behind the link. So spammers use this a lot. So what are the consequences of this? You might get on your website a message such as this. So if you click on some links, perhaps when you use Bitly, they will possibly, I'm not sure they will certainly, but they will possibly show you a warning message prior to giving you the link. So this is not so good because perhaps unknowing to you, you get into some sort of list and you don't know about it, and you just create a link with Bitly and you send it to someone else. And then when that person visits the website, it gives the person a warning message and it doesn't get to the website and it's frustration. So this is not so good. If you send an email, perhaps the person receiving an email with Bitly marks it as spam. And if enough people do it, perhaps all your messages which have Bitly links on them may be marked as spam. Other services have the same problem, I detail here. Finally, if someone constantly sees that, for example, Bitly links are used in affiliate networks, and you send that person a link shortened with Bitly, then that person might be tempted not to click on your link based on previous experiences. People fear the unknown. So, in StumbleUpon, you just visit the website and it gives you something random to look at. And you click Stumble and it gives you something else. And it's quite popular, but the reason for this, I think, is that it knows what you like and you don't like. So it has such a vast network and database of people, and it has some powerful algorithms that it knows what to show you and what not to show you. And if I give you a link shortened with tiny URL, you don't know where you land. So people would much rather be afraid than happy with this tiny URL thing. So consider this as a not shortening reason. There's another reason. It takes time and effort to create one. Even if I just click on this, it's still a step. But for people who don't have a browser extension, it takes time to create a tiny URL. You should avoid having long URLs in the first place. So this URL looks much better when you have it like this. So, but you can also just link it like this. So this is a pretty short URL in itself. There's a blogger called Derek Sievers, and his links are almost always like this, so very short URLs. So what you can do, and I would suggest you to do, is edit posts, and you should be able to edit the URLs and make them shorter. So this is short enough to be forwarded and give to other people without worrying that it's too long. So you should focus on this. Counter reason for using URL shortenings is that it takes some time to load. So if I visit bit.ly, it took this time, and now if I visit bit.ly, it's about the same time so it wasn't significantly higher. Let's do it again. This one and this one. I don't know, it was pretty much the same. But consider this, people have made some tests, and it takes a while for the URL to be redirected. So it will make the experience a bit longer. So if I just give you go to google.com, or give you a link go to bit.ly, which redirects you to google.com, it will be longer if the person clicks on the bit.ly link. But the latency is small, so it's not a huge problem, but just consider it as a factor. Okay, so 301 redirects, I told you at the beginning of the video that all three websites which I recommend are using it. So 301 redirects must be good. Actually, no, it still loses some link juice. So if I give you a link to your website, website.com, it's a bit better from an SEO perspective than that same link with Google and bit.ly. Matt Cutt says in this video that what I'm saying right now is false, but have a look at this article. Okay, conclusions. Read this article. It says the following, that analytics should not interfere with usability. And yes, people use URL shorteners for analytics data, but in my opinion, and that person's also, analytics should not interfere with the interests of the readers. So this is an important thing. You shouldn't put more emphasis on analytics than the interests of the readers. Read this. Okay, read these two articles to decide which URL shortener to use. If you don't like URL shorteners, there are extensions which, instead of displaying you a short URL, instead of this, they will show you the long URL. So have a look at these two extensions. And I use this extension, which makes shorter URLs, but Google this and you will find the other extensions that integrate into the browser. I have previously used tiny URL in my history, then I switched to bit.ly, then to Google. I now currently make URLs so short that they don't need URL shortening services. I would suggest you to use either Google or bit.ly. So, yes, the same advice here. Try to shorten the URLs. Bit.ly or Google shows you the stats, but at Google you have to be logged in. Even if you create the link like this, so the person just has to click, have a look in this area. So this is a long URL. and this is a short URL redirecting. So the user might use this copy and paste. And for the user, it's better, I think, to have a short URL. This is, so I'm not sure with this one. I generally use this thing. But there is a logic of using a short URL for paste and copy and paste. So consider it like this. This is a URL by YouTube. And as you can see, it has a question mark and a dash. I would suggest you to avoid using them in URLs, generally for Notepad reasons. So if I just take this text and put it to Notepad, and if I double click here, look, it has a question mark and it has a minus and it stops right there. Had it not had this, let's try it like this. Now it's selecting the whole URL. Okay. Where should you use URL shorteners? When should you use URL shorteners? When you send a link, I repeated that because I paused the video. Okay, sorry. So when you send a link to an email and in the email and the link is more than one line long, it might break. But it might also not. But so I suggest you to use it because of copy paste mostly. So generally it won't break, but people would copy paste the link and sometimes, and it's better if it's a shorter URL. But and if it's a very long URL, this probability increases higher, increases much. Regarding books, I would suggest you to have both the short URLs and the long URLs because one to another. So you should have this and no. This and this at the same time, short and long. People would not understand what's the long URL about. I gave a poor example because in here you understand that it's YouTube and these are the only two variables. But generally, so this is a long URL and this is a shorter one, even though even this was a poor example. Okay, I think you will get what I meant. Okay. Okay. I think you should use the short links embedded into the network. So if YouTube gives you this link and Flickr gives you this link and Google Maps gives you this link, you should use the following links. For affiliate links, if you want the person not to be able to click on anything else, use shorter links. And if you want to put it on Facebook on various places and you don't know which links were more clicked. So if you put it to five Facebook groups and five pages, all you will see in your Google Analytics data is that you made a link. You will have traffic from Facebook. That's it. That's all you know. But if you make 10 different URL short URLs, you'll know, okay, so this short URL gave me this. This short URL gave me this. You can use some Google Analytics parameters and you can have this data right in the Google Analytics. But it's best when you share it on a Facebook group or page, it's best to have it short URL first. So when you send an SMS, this is also likely you should use a short URL. You should avoid using them if the social networks allows you to use a long URL with no problems, but it's not so clear. So social networks are more prone to this than others. Okay. So on Facebook and Google Plus, you should avoid, I'm not sure what I meant to, I will pause it. Okay, so now I got it. On Facebook and Google Plus, you should avoid using short URLs because they handle long URLs fine. You should also avoid using them on LinkedIn and Twitter because they are automatically shortened. So other networks, I'm not sure. Okay. When you post something on Facebook and you don't check statistics. So I've seen this happening. I've seen people using Bitly because their competition was using Bitly, but they never checked statistics. So no, this is a bad reason. Finally, when you share a link with a large group of persons and that URL needs to be alive and there are no valid reasons for shortening, avoid using this. And I will give one more reason which I forgot to put in the blog. Okay, I will post this in the article. URL shorteners might not be the best solution for sharing a link on social network because it might decrease the engagement rate. So you might consider not using URL shorteners because people are likely to be afraid of using them. So I'll post this in the article also. Okay, thank you. Bye.